ESG investing, which focuses on companies that receive high marks in environmental, social, and governance factors, was a growing market before the pandemic. But since coronavirus hit, socially conscious investing has become even more popular with investors. ESG index funds have topped more than $250 billion, with the U.S. market accounting for about 20% of that total. Joining me to discuss these ESG investing trends and more is Jonathan Bailey. He's the Managing Director of ESG Investing at Neuberger Berman. So, Jonathan, over the course of this year with the pandemic, we've seen more social activism, especially around issues related to racial injustice and climate change. Is that translating to more demand for ESG investing? What have you seen in terms of growth?
Well, Alexis, it's a great question. And it's the question that a lot of our clients are asking themselves. You know, what is my money doing? Is it part of the solution to these pressing environmental and social challenges that have been so visible to so many of us through the course of this year? And what we've seen is increased interest, flows, and ultimately market valuation premiums resulting from the focus on environmental, social, and governance factors. And I think that is something that's not going to change as the world slowly emerges from the challenges of the year, because clients are now looking more closely at what's in their portfolio and asking tougher questions of their managers as to how their investment processes look at these clearly material topics, everything from how tech companies are thinking about gender and racial equality through to the role that the energy sector has in the transition to a low carbon economy. So there's a lot of great dialogue that we're having with clients, and they're trusting us to be part of the solution.
Right. And I think one of the big concerns, or maybe kind of one of the stereotypes I feel like investors have about ESG investing, means that you might sacrifice performance, you know, to have these feel good investments. Is that necessarily the case?
Well, clearly we don't believe so, but the data also backs us up. If you look at Morningstar's assessment of several hundred mutual funds, both in 2019, right before we had this market volatility, and in the course of 2020 so far, funds that have a focus on sustainable investment practices have outperformed their peers. Here at Neuberger Berman, we found through the course of the market volatility of 2020, that all but one of our sustainable and impact strategies have added meaningful alpha. And we think that's because they're invested in businesses that have a higher quality, are delivering products and services that are more essential, and have great quality management teams that have been able to look around the corner to ensure that they have more resilient businesses as they come under pressure. So we think that there's absolutely a link between strong long-term investment performance and ESG rather than the other way around.
Right. And when it comes to prioritizing these principles, I mean, is it more important that a company reduce its carbon footprint or have a more diverse board? I mean, how do you gauge those terms in terms of looking at the overall portfolio performance?
You're right. And there are themes like climate that apply, you know, quite broadly across companies. But we try and take a sector by sector view of what we think is financially material. So, you know, for example, if you're looking at a sector like the automotive sector, you know, we want to understand things like worker health and safety in manufacturing plants. We want to understand how the vehicle fleet is going to become more efficient and the longer term transition towards electric vehicles and, you know, autonomous driving and all the capabilities that may create for those auto manufacturers. You know, those are going to be quite different than in a software company, where we're going to look at issues like diversity in the hiring practices as you try and retain and attract the top engineering talent. We're going to want to understand how you think about using your market power. Are you abusing it and, you know, hoarding intellectual property that's going to attract regulatory and legal scrutiny? And of course, you know, one of the things that a lot of the big tech companies are doing today is they are running a lot of data centers, either directly or indirectly. So they actually have quite a big carbon footprint. So what are you doing to reduce the emissions from those data centers, either by using renewable power or by using offsets? So the topics are slightly different sector by sector, but as I hope those couple of examples have shown you, the key thing is to get the specifics that allow you to compare companies within a sector against each other to decide who you want in your portfolio.
Right. And like you said, so much of this can kind of reveal the fundamentals of the company. And, you know, I think when we look at certain investment styles, I know we'd like to promote a growth investment strategy. And sometimes these ESG principles can seem so far off in the distance. But how do you feel that they complement growth investing strategies?
Well, I think one of the things that often happens is, you know, that when you're buying a growth stock, you're putting a lot of weight on that terminal value and you're paying a premium in the multiple because you believe the company's going to earn its way into that. And if you look at what's happened in multiple expansion over the last year and a half, it's been the ESG leaders that have seen more of that multiple expansion. So I think, you know, just from a technical perspective, right, looking at ESG as a way of forecasting which companies are positioning themselves for that sort of secular thematic trend for growth that may not yet be fully appreciated by the market, but that once it is, and the company does a better job of explaining it, that then may see a multiple expansion. But then on the fundamental side, I mean, clearly the opportunity to compound growth through delivering products and services that are more efficient, that are more innovative. You know, we've seen that with names like Tesla and Beyond Meat, right, where arguably the valuation has got, you know, slightly beyond the fundamentals. But there is a good growth story based on ESG fundamentals with names like that, that, you know, for investors earlier on in the process, you know, definitely saw the opportunity.
Well, Jonathan, thanks so much for your insights today.
It's been lovely to be here.
And you can learn more about ESG investing in our special report over at investors.com. For Investors Business Daily, I'm Alexis Garcia.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching Investors Business Daily on YouTube. If you want to watch more videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a thing.